eBay has much to celebrate. At 10 years old, it's the biggest online marketplace around the globe, with an expected $40 billion worth of goods traded on its platform this year. eBay, which takes a broker's fee for those transactions, generated $1 billion in sales in the first quarter, the first time ever in a three-month period. But earlier this year, eBay raised its prices, testing the loyalty of longtime sellers. Some attending eBay Live decided it was time to look beyond eBay to sell their goods.
Customers are in many places, and so we want to be where different customers are, and hence the expansion into other channels.
We're advertising on other sources like Google AdWords, Overture, and other shopping comparison engines.
As sellers set up shop off eBay and advertise on Google and Yahoo, eBay responded by buying comparison shopping site Shopping.com and launching Pro Stores.
eBay's mission has always been to help our sellers be successful, and we do whatever they need to help them grow their business. The first thing we do, of course, is bring them buyers, but over the years we've added seller tools and different formats. So this is part of a natural evolution to make sure that our sellers do most of their business, first and foremost, on the net.
Meg, 2005 is shaping up to be a very challenging year. Sellers are defecting. What are you doing to address those concerns?
If I step back and say, what am I hearing generally speaking, certainly is questions, how do I continue to grow my business? Where do I get source of supply? Many of our sellers don't know where now to go to get incremental supply to put on eBay. And you saw we announced a deal with Global Sources to help bring supply to our power sellers, and we also launched the reseller marketplace.
Still, investors aren't convinced eBay can maintain its lead. They've been dumping eBay in favor of Google since the start of this year. Today, Google at $85 billion in value is nearly twice the size of eBay at 45, and Google is just getting started.
Google is planning to launch its own online payment service. How will this compete with PayPal off of the eBay platform?
I think really, regardless of what Google does, there's going to be a real opportunity for PayPal.
But observers say eBay may have to share that opportunity.
Google has a lot of assets to bring to bear as well. They have, it's estimated 1 million advertisers that spend, billions of dollars in advertising with Google. So it'll be an interesting fight to watch to see who gets the share there.
To stay competitive, sellers and analysts say eBay has to add value.
They can simplify their tools, they can add more, they can actually add more productized tools, they can communicate better with their community so they're not up in arms every time they raise their fees.
As a company, eBay is clearly still the dominant provider as an auction marketplace. It is still the number one place to sell anything to anyone in terms of the way they look at their business. And right now, today, what they're looking at is they're saying they have this great core business. How do they add to it?
Global trade, where a buyer and a seller is in a different country, will be a bigger part of our overall business.
As any seller knows, you've got to go where the buyers are. Regardless of the competition, many say eBay's still the place to set up shop. In San Jose, California, I'm Bambi Francisco, MarketWatch.